Allahu Akbar.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And jazakumullah khair for staying with us for the continuation of the ICNA Dawah Conference. Dr. Jonathan is an associate professor and chair of Islamic Civilization at Georgetown University. He is the editor-in-chief of the Oxford Encyclopedia of Islam and Law, and the author of several books, including Misquoting Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, The Challenges and Choices of Interpreting the Prophet's Legacy.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, and alhamdulillah, bin astayin, wa salatu wa salam ala sayyidil muslimin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. I was asked to talk about why bad things happen to good people. At least that's what I remember reading. I hope that's the topic. Now, that's also the title of a best, many thousands and millions of copies sold bestseller, I think by a Jewish author, if I'm not mistaken, translated into so many languages. I've never seen it sold in the Muslim world, which is interesting. And I think it's because if there's one thing I've always been really impressed with Muslims ever since I became Muslim, was that they don't seem to have this anxiety as much as other people do. They don't seem to be tried by this question and afflicted by this question as much as other people. And I think that's because the Quran is very clear the fact, in effect, that this question is completely inappropriate, right? First of all, let me talk about why bad things happen to good people, right? No things are bad or good in and of themselves. So the Quran talks about how, you know, our children and beautiful things and our property and our lives and our health. I mean, think about children. What's better than children, right? Our children are both a blessing and they're a test. They're a fitna for us, right? So everything that is good is that is pleasant and pleasing to us is both a blessing and also a test to us, right? How do we react to it? And things that seem bad, like an injury or death or loss, right? They are a test for us, right? So they're something that gives us a chance to succeed and to gain, not just to lose, right? So the first thing is that there's no such thing as good or bad things in and of themselves. It's how we react to them. And the second is that whether or not you're a good person or not has nothing to do with you getting tested. Of course, good people are going to be tested, and they're going to be tested by losing things, right? So the Quran says, you know, God says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. Do people think that they're just going to say, oh, we believe, so we're wonderful people, we're believers now, and you're not going to be tested? You're not going to have this fitna? So, I mean, these two concepts that are really important are the concept of fitna and bala, right? So fitna means it's a test, it's a trial for you. Good things are a test for you, and bad things are a test for you, or things that seem good are a test for you, or things that seem bad are a test for you. And similar with bala. Bala is testing something to see if it performs well. So you can be tested, and it can be an opportunity to show that you can succeed. And you can be tested, and it's an opportunity for you to fail. That's really how you react. That's important. And this is made very clear by Allah Subhanahu wa Taala in the Quran. The Quran says, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَثَمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Right? So God says, surely we're going to test you. We're going to test you with fear, with hunger, with loss of your property and of lives and of fruits of your labor, right? So here's the second part that's important to keep in mind, which is, what is the second half of the equal sign, right? So the reason that the question of why do bad things happen to good people is so stressful and almost existentially critical for a lot of people in the world is that people don't take the idea of the afterlife seriously at all, right? So if you only have this world, if this world is all that exists, then you look around, you see, you know, a child die, or you see an innocent person killed, or thousands of innocent people killed, right, by some dictator, Whereas if you believe in afterlife, there's another side of the equal sign, where all these things are equaled out, right? So the Quran says, "La tahsabanna Allah ghafilan amma ya'malu adh-dhalimun," right? So God, don't think that God is unaware of what the oppressive people do. Innama yu'akhiruhum liyawmin tashkhasu fihi al-absar, right? So rather, God is delaying their punishment for a day when all the eyes are going to be opened. Everything will be revealed. And people will see what they've done and be punished for what they've done or be rewarded for what they've done, right? So if you have another side of the equal sign, then the suffering of good people or the death or loss of innocent people, that can be repaid. Those people who suffer get repaid thousands of times with the rewards in the afterlife. And those who committed those crimes get punished. You know, and this is a very important concept in the Quran. Man dha alladhi yuqridu Allaha qardan hasana. Who's going to be the person who gives God a goodly loan? You give God a loan of struggling with your life and your wealth and being grateful and bearing loss with patience in this life. And then you get that back multiple times in the afterlife, right? So that verse that says, indeed, we are going to try you with fear and hunger and loss in your wealth and in yourselves and your lives and your labors, right? But then it says, Bashir al-Sabirin, give good tidings to those who are patient in adversity, who bear loss and who say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, right? So those, the next verse, those people who say when something bad happens to them, we belong to God, to him returning. If you are sabr, if you have sabr, then you pass the test. So the fitna is the test. Whether it's good, if you get a good thing, you're tested. What are you going to do with this good thing? Are you going to think it came from you, or do you think that you always remember that all blessings come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are you going to do good with this thing, or are you going to waste it and do bad with it? That's your test. If you lose something, whether it's your health or property or a loved one, right? How are you going to react to this? Are you going to get angry at God? Are you going to get angry and give up and say God doesn't do anything for me, or stop believing or something, or go and hurt other people? Or are you going to say, Alhamdulillah, that I had this thing, I had my health, I was given all these blessings. When I had them, I hope I used them well. And now my job is to simply say again, I'm so grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he gave me anything in this world, that I was given the blessing of existence, and I pray for mercy on those people who died, right? And then that I'm given a reward for for what I go through and bear in this world, right? So you don't fall into kufr, which is fundamentally ingratitude towards God. So this is the two things to keep in mind when we think about this, as I said, very false or an improper question, why do bad things happen to good people? Because good people get tested, just like bad people get tested. And we're told we're going to lose things in this world. And the question is, how do we respond to that? Do we respond with gratitude to God and patience, or do we respond with despair, which is, as the Prophet says, alayhi salam, a tool of the devil, a tool of the devil. Despair is a tool of the devil. Okay, I think that was all that I was supposed to say.
Jazakallah khair for an inspiring talk. And Jazakallah khair. And inshallah, with that, we will conclude. Once again, you can support us financially by donating at icna.org/donate, or help volunteer at Embrace, YSLAM, Gain Peace, and other chapters by visiting icna.org/barakah. Jazakallah khair.